Hi everyone, today video tutorial is about Apache Maven. In this video tutorial we are going to see what is Apache Maven and how to embed a Selenium web driver script in Apache Maven. So you can see here Apache Maven is a software project management and a comprehensive tool. So normally Apache Maven means it is used to manage a Java project. And it is a comprehensive tool. It is nothing but in this tool we can able to create all the concepts like managing the project, adding jar files to the project, compiling, executing, documentation, reporting, everything can be done using Apache Maven. If you are creating a class like Maven project, you will be having a four main structures. The structure is source code, test source, test, distributory jars, and then it is a compiled code. In source code, you will be having the source code of the project, and in resource, you will be having the test related resources or classes, and test, you will be having the related test for your project, and distributed jar, you will have all the jar files related to your project. And now you can see here, this is the Eclipse. Normally you will be creating the Java project. Here if you want to see whether Apache Maven is in Eclipse, just click on help, about Eclipse. You can see here M2E. So this M2E represent Maven to Eclipse plugin. So if it is available, your Eclipse will support Maven project. In default, Kepler and above version has a Maven project. So here what you are going to do, you are going to create a Maven project. So if it is not available in your Eclipse, just go to Eclipse marketplace and search Maven plugin for Eclipse. So it will be available and you just install to your Eclipse, it will work. You can see here the Maven plugin for Eclipse, just select the version and you can install. This is one way to install your Maven to your Eclipse. Now, normally if you are creating a Java project, you will have a source and the library. But here, the project structure will be divided into five categories. That is source main, test main, and Java resource, test resource, next is the target. Now you can see this is the structure. While I'm creating a Maven project, you can see the structure of the Maven. So it is different from Java project. So now file, new, just see here, you will see Maven project. Select Maven project. So here you are going to should select a simple archetype. Archetype is nothing but a structure, or you can tell it as a type, template. Now you just give a group ID and an artifact ID. Group ID is nothing but which group, that a project group, or we can tell it as a in under which category our project is. So group ID you have to give. An artifact ID is a project name. So group ID is like what is the category or project. And next you are going to see it is an artifact ID. So after giving a group ID, for example, if it is facebook.com, you can give com.facebook. Okay, so with your domain and then the type of project, and you can give the artifact ID and the version. So if it is first version, you can give first, or you can change the version number and the packaging. Once if you are giving finish, you can see here Maven project has been creating. So there is some difference, like difference between a normal Java and a Maven project. Normal Java you will execute like Java application, but Maven you will execute like Maven project. Now you can see here four folders has been created. In JRE all the jar files is available, and next for Maven dependency is there. Here annexed the target bin and a target folder has been created. So this is how your structure of your Maven will be. So whenever you are executing your Maven file, you will be executing like POM XML file. Like in Apache and you will have build.xml. Same in Apache and Apache Maven, you will be having POM XML file. So POM stands for Project Object Model or Page Object Model. So it will work according to the object model. Now you can see it is in XML file format and it is model, group ID, artifact ID and version, and the group ID is e-learning and artifact ID is online course. Now whatever operation you are doing, you have to run your Maven project using POM XML only. So once after creating, you have to give install. Only then whatever jar files or dependency related to your project will get installed in your workspace. So here you have to give run as, select your POM XML file, run as Maven install. So if you are installing from the central repository, every jar files will be installed to your workspace. So you can see here installed all the plugins, online courses, and you can see from the global repositories it have installed and it have created a jar file. So once it is created a jar file, you can able to use this jar file anywhere in a project. Whenever, for example, if you want to inherit the project or if you want to extend the reuse the project, you can use this jar file alone. You don't want to create all the project once again. And you can see in dependency, we don't have any dependency. So if you want any dependency, like if you want any database connectivity, or if you want Selenium web driver, or if you want JXL, JUnit, TestNG, whatever dependency you want, you can add it in this dependency folder, or you can directly add to your POM XML file. Now I am going to create a class. The package name is there, and next you are going to give a class name. So create the class. So now you just give system.out Apache Maven demo for Selenium test. Just I am going to show you how the Maven structure will execute. So you can embed your Selenium code to your Maven. So Apache Maven demo for Selenium test I have given. Now this is the class name. And now come to your POM XML file. Run as Maven build. So if I am giving Maven build, let's see what will be the output. Maven build is used to run. So here we have to run it. So where it is available, according to that only we have to run. So just give clean.java. Sorry, clean.run you have to give. Now you can see build failure, could not find the goal run in plugin. So you here, if you are executing a Java code in POM XML, the goal should be correct. So like whatever, if you want to clean or install or build or run, whatever you have to give, you have to give it in a goal. But this goal is invalid because to run a Java project, you need a dependency. For that, you are having a Maven repository. From the Maven repository, you can able to choose any dependency to your project. So here I am giving dependency. So either you want dependency or plugin, you have to choose. So before giving dependency, you have to give in a build tag. So inside build tag, you can either give it in dependency or you can give it in plugin. If you want to execute it, you have to give it in plugin. So give source directory where your source file is. So the source file is in src main Java. And here you are going to give the plugin. So plugin, what plugin you need for executing your Java code? You need exe maven plugin. So just select here, give the group ID, artifact ID of exe maven plugin in your plugins, and after that you have to give which class you have to execute. So give main class. In main class you have to give package name dot class name. So you can see the package name is online course and the class name is sample maven test. So you have to give inside the tag. So main class and close the tag, in between the open and close tag you have to give online course dot sample maven test. Now you have configured your POM XML file for executing your Java program. So here just run as you have to give and build. So in and build you have to give here package space exe colon java space hyphen x. So you can see here the output. Your file has been loaded and all the details, JRE and every life cycle like initiate, pre-init, documentation, validation, every phases it's installed, and configuration, everything will be done according to your execute Maven plugin. And next you can see here the debug phases. And next you can see included, excluded files. At last you will be getting your result. Just see here, all the values for your particular project has been given here. And next you can see, it is like for the jar file, whatever the file name, everything is here. And next it have downloaded all the Maven dependencies, plugins, and now you can see here your test has been executed. So it have initiated your run from the Maven local repository, and you can see here build success and the result before after debug Apache Maven demo for Selenium test, it have executed. So this is how you have to run your POM XML file. So now if you want to create any other class like demo test, if you want to execute this also, it's not a problem. The same procedure you have to follow here. The procedure is like you have to give the package name and the class name to your project. So in POM XML, you have to give in main class whatever package and the class name correctly. Once if you are giving the package name and class name correctly, you can able to run your Java code very easily. So this is how you have to execute the Java code using Selenium, Java code using Apache Maven. So whatever jar file you need, just go to the Maven repository and copy the dependency and paste it in your POM XML file so that all this will be supported. You don't want to download, install everything. Just give the dependency, automatically it will get all the details from the particular URL and the particular group. So this is how you will be using your Apache Maven. In next session, what we are going to see in like, we are going to embed a Selenium WebDriver code in Apache Maven and we are going to execute using exe maven plugin. If you want to use any other execution, means according to your project, the execution plugin you can select in your Apache Maven. So this is the main advantage of Apache Maven, so that we will call Apache Maven as a management tool. It is used to manage all type of applications in your particular, even web application also managed in Apache Maven. Thank you.